Hello mates, welcome to Finally Mates Live. I'll be live streaming while working on some comic pages and inking, sketching, penciling, all that stuff. I won't be accompanied by anyone, but I wanted to try live streaming on my own. So I'll try to keep talking and keep this live stream alive. And if you guys have any questions, just ask them in the chat and I'll try to answer them. I'll share my other screen so you guys can see what I'm doing. Let's see. This screen share. Okay, I hope you guys can see my screen. Let's see. Present to everyone. Yes. Okay, let's start. So as you guys can see, I have a couple of pages here. This over here is page 1, 2, and 3, and I'm currently penciling page 3. So let's see how that goes. And in the meantime, I'm hoping a couple of more people will join the stream. But yeah, I won't be streaming for long, but we'll just see how it goes. Yeah. Okay. Sorry guys, I'm closing a few windows and hoping this stream doesn't lag or something. Okay. Let's get started. And remember, if you have questions or something like that, don't be afraid to ask them. I'll be happy to answer them. And I will try not to stay quiet. That can be tricky if you're live streaming on your own. So let's try to keep talking, to keep this alive. So, okay. I'm just going to be refining the sketches. So as you can see, the blue is my layout page, my layout layer, and I created a new layer with a red color that I'll be refining the rough layouts. I hope you guys can hear me. Oh, A-okay. But I think that's the case. Okay. I won't be saying too much about the page, but I can if you guys have questions or something about it. Okay, let's see. When I'm penciling, usually I would pencil it on paper and then scan it in, but I'm trying something new and maybe I can remove that kind of step because I think it's extra work. And I don't like doing stuff extra, but I'll see how this goes. And if I don't like it, I'll maybe return to penciling on paper and doing that. And off camera, I have a lot of reference sheet for the characters because I don't have all the characters memorized yet, so that I still need to look up some reference and see how that goes. But the main character, I think I can draw him from my head. I don't know if he'll look good, but I can do that. And practicing your characters is pretty important. But in your comic, when you're drawing them over and over, they'll get stuck in your head. I think Masashi Kishimoto can draw Naruto in his sleep, so that comes pretty automatic, so Don't worry about that. Okay. I'm just making this whole part red because that is going to be black, I think, in the inking process. So I'm indicating that. And I don't know what the interaction latency is, but I hope it's not too much. Okay. The reason I didn't invite anyone for this live stream is because it wasn't really planned, but then I remember that in the poll, people said that most of you were available on a Saturday, so I'll see if that is true. And it's pretty late in the Netherlands, but I know that other places in the world it's pretty early, so I hope most people can catch this live stream. Okay, let's make that entire part red. Yeah, something like that. So how detailed do I go with my pencils? I don't make it too detailed because I still have to ink it. And if I do all the work with my penciling, the inking will be pretty boring. And actually it will be me tracing over my red pencils. And with the inking, I still want to add a new level of depth to the drawing. So that's what I'm trying to do. I'm hoping I can make some progress. Let's see how far I can come. Because last stream I was like drawing one page the entire live stream. And I think that's what you get when you're live streaming with other people. They can distract you. But this time, I do want to make some progress. So, something like this. Oops, that happens sometimes. Okay, let's see. One sec, checking something. Okay, let's see, guys. I know I'm quiet again, but it's really difficult to keep talking and drawing at the same time. Not that it's difficult, but you can run out of stuff to say pretty easily. So, yeah, that's the case right now, right here. See ya, bro. But I'll try to live stream more because live streaming is my way of doing, sorry. Live streaming is my way of doing some real-time drawing on my YouTube channel, and not only live stream videos. I mean, time-lapse videos. What I can do is the drawings I make in the live stream, I can record them and then time-lapse them and upload them. But my computer is not strong enough to live stream and record my screen at the same time. So that will have to wait. So talking about the comic, like I don't know if some of you are wondering when you can read it, but I'm hoping at the end of August, like yeah, at the end of August, something like that. I want to make it available to read. So let's see if I can do that. Maybe not, but I want to. So I'm gonna try it. And I've been working really hard on the story. So yeah. Hope you guys enjoy it. If not, too bad. If you do, yay. But I think you guys will enjoy the story. It's compelling, in my opinion. Again, I won't be live streaming long. I think an hour top. But because I didn't upload a fan art video yesterday, I wanted to do something today. So this is me kind of making up. Sorry, there's a baby in the background. Okay, let's see. I'm going to finish her hair and then move on to page three. Again, looking at my reference sheet to how her hair moves. Okay, let's see, something like that. So, okay. Coming back in, zooming out a bit, and there we have it. Okay, something like that. And starting here, her hair then moves all the way down. All the way. Oops. Sometimes my Cintiq draws really big lines. I don't know why, so don't ask me. I think it's something with the software. Maybe it's outdated. I may have to update it, but I don't want to upset it or something. So I'll just leave it. Yeah, that sounds good. Let's see. Let's make it curl down like this and make that come in like this. Okay. Okay, that's about how I want it. So let's keep it that way. So yeah, lately I've been watching a lot of Steven Universe. I don't know why. I think it's really good for some reason. And I'm not done watching all the episodes, but that's mostly what's distracting me from drawing and making videos. So I don't know why. Let's see. Okay. And I think I want to make the reason why I want to keep the live stream videos when I'm by myself short is I don't want to bore people, and I want people to be able to watch it back once I've uploaded. And when a video is 4 hours long, that's pretty long video for someone to watch. Most of the people will just skip through it, and I understand it. I do it myself. So I think if the video is shorter, people will watch, may watch the entire thing or even half of it. So that's already good. So that's the reason, not because I don't want to stream longer with you guys. And I'm going to invite more people. The more people I can invite, the better. I hope my people, I hope my computer can handle that many people. But we'll see. We'll see. If it explodes, then I know it can't handle all those people. Okay, I'm just highlighting a few things, or not highlighting, but or just putting lines. Yeah, let's call it putting lines. Okay, I'm liking it. Let's zoom out. Yeah, I think we can do the borders. Let's do the borders. That's the most exciting thing I'm going to be drawing today. So yeah, I think most of you can then imagine how fun my day has been. When I'm doing borders, I'm looking for a fun custom brush that I can do. Now that's too customized. I want to keep it simple, but a fun brush. Let's see. I think this one will do. And let's pick a black color. Yeah, that's fine. And when you press shift, you can get straight lines. So remember that. So, okay. Let's see. I want to keep it higher. Make the border higher. Higher. See. Higher. Higher. See. Down to beats. Okay. Yeah, that's okay. There and oh wait. There. Oops. Sorry, something is and a bit thicker. Okay, and sometimes it does that. I don't know why, but it just does. I'm going to make this one bigger as well. Let's see. Wait. 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 I think there. Too fat. The noise you're hearing is just my keyboard. I'm pressing it. Using my lasso tool to erase borderlines that are being overlapped. And I'm going in and refining the edges. Okay. That's right. See, okay. That's also good. And I'm going to be doing the text balloons also. So we'll see how that goes. But that's the first border. High five, guys. Let's see. Oh, we have Royal Samurai in the chat. Hi, Royal Samurai. Thanks for tuning in. I appreciate it. I'm just doing some comic stuff, penciling my pages, inking the borders. So that's what's happening. Let's see. Okay. You haven't missed anything, really. I've just penciled the red woman's face, as you can see. And now I'm doing the borders, so that's pretty exciting. Not. Let's see. I want to align this with that. Hey, borders are coming along, guys. And let's see, we have about three borders in on this page. Let's see, on the other page we have five panels, not borders, panels. Let's see, wait, I want to increase the size of my brush. And going, oh, too big, I think. Let's bring it down to around 24 pixels. Okay. Okay, I'm liking how the borders are looking. And doing the borders with a texture brush is, I think, better than with a regular flat brush or with the line tool. Gives it more life, texture. The lines aren't too clean. Oh, oops. Let's zoom in there and erase those. And why I'm pulling the lines straight ahead is so that I know that the borders are aligned. Yeah, something like that. Let's delete this a bit more. And this, okay. This one over here. And this one over here. Okay, then we have one here. So, yeah, and I think this one also, but I'm not sure yet because the text balloon still has to be added. Okay, and while we're at it, let's add the text balloon of these pages and then move on to the next page. The previous one, I also need to add the text balloons, so let's do that. Okay, let's see. I think something like that. And what I'm going to do, I'll be bringing this to around 50, the feather. And why I'm doing that is it's cleaning my lasso tool. It's making the lines not so wiggly. If I do this, and then this, you see it cleans it up. And if you bring it to 100% or 100 pixel, if I do this with my lasso tool and then do this, it makes it pretty round, as you can see. Do you mean Photoshop, Royal Samurai, or Manga Studio? Because I use quite a lot of drawing programs, but if you mean Photoshop, you can connect me via Google Hangout and I'll send you a link where you can download it. And the same goes for Manga Studio. But I don't want the feather at, let's bring it at 75, something like that. More this. Okay. No, let's bring it at 50%, guys. Yeah, Photoshop. Okay. Connect me via Google Hangout, and after the stream, I'll send you a link where you can download it so you can experiment with it. And you can download the trial version. It's the same, only it's limited. But in the during the trial, you can figure out if you like the program or not. Let's see. Yeah, that's what I like. Okay. And what I'm going to do is, let's see. Oh no, now I need the feather to be at 0. Okay, I think I want it more like, no, not like that, or like this. Yeah, I like that. And let's fill it with a cool color. I think blue or something. Let's see. Why is it? That's pretty weird. Let's bring this to one. Don't know why my screw it. I'm going to do it manually and color it with my brush. Okay, it appears that the selection I made is being completely weird, and I don't know why. Let's see. Let's reselect it. Something like, sometimes Photoshop really like X up, and I don't know why. But let's see. What if I just too big? I want it more like this. Oh wait, I'm just going to grab this here. Yeah, that's fine. And fill it. And grab my selection tool. And repeat the same thing I did. Oh wait. No. Okay. Yeah, I'm liking that. So, my first text balloon, guys. Let's see. When I zoom out, yeah, it still looks pretty good. But I'm going to clean the edges of it. Okay. Okay. I'm just refining the edges of my text balloon. Let's see. Okay. Okay. I'm liking the first text balloon, so I'm staying with it. And if I erase the layout layer, it's looking pretty neat. Let's see, I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. Yeah, something like that. Okay, let's do this one. Grab the ellipse tool, and I need to make it bigger and better. Okay, something like that. Let's see, does it cover the entire text area? I'm going to make it slightly bigger. Okay. Yes, that's good. Let's add the arrow key that's going to be pointing at his mouth. This and this. Okay, zoom in a bit, refining the point. Yes. Okay, I'm liking it. I see what you mean, Royal Samurai. So, I think it would look better if I would hold a box on a piece of paper and then bring it together. Yeah, that's a choice, but it's a good one, a smart one, I think. So you can edit it on your computer, and it's like when you're making a movie and you're like filming a couple of scenes, and then the editing brings it together, and afterwards you can decide what kind of scenes you want together and what doesn't work. So it's a great idea. And nice for working on your comic. Okay, let's make this bigger. So, text balloons look easy in comics, but they can take up a lot of work, especially when they're hand-drawn, I think. Okay, let's do hers. I'm just picking colors that I think the text balloon, but afterwards I can still change them if I don't like them. Let's see, I don't want to cover too much line art. And I do want the text balloons to be close, but not too close. Okay. That or the text balloons on this page. Oh, wait, I forgot one. How could I forget one? I'm horrible. Let's do this one, guys. Too big. Too big. And like when I'm doing my layout, I already sketch the text that is going to be in the text balloon, and I think that's pretty handy. So you don't have to wait to the till the last minute. And when you're sketching it, the text helps you remind what's going to be in the page and what it should illustrate. Clouds leaning over the edge. Which clouds? I think it's okay, yeah. Well, do I have to erase that bit? I don't know why I drew that. I'm going to do it in a bit. Oh yeah, that's definitely okay, the clouds there. Like when I'm going to be inking it, I'm going to refine it. So stuff like that will be erased. Let's see, this is big enough. Is it or is it too big? Let's see, oh wait, I'm going to bring it down. So bring it back. Oh, oops. Text clouds. Yeah, it's definitely okay if the text clouds are leaning over the edge. Like it gives it some kind of depth if the clouds are all out of the border or covering it. Like if you're keeping your clouds in the border, it's like you're confining them. And if you're keeping it, bringing them out of the border, it's like they're breaking the page, and it gives more of a dramatic effect, in my opinion. Let's see. And if you make your clouds too big, like bigger than your text, it's indicating that the reader should breathe or read the text slowly. And if you make your clouds small, like the exact size of your text, they should read it fast or hard, something like that. Let's see. Okay. And now adding the pointer. And you can't see it right now, but the person that is actually standing there is this person here. So pretty unclear, but what the hey, right? Oh, wrong thing. Let's see. Or do I want it straight? Can be straight. Wait. Ha, sensei. No, I'm not. I'm not a sensei. I myself have like a lot to learn. So, sorry to disappoint you. Want it more like that. Okay, if I do this, then I can see what I did. and if I like it or not. Most of the time I don't like it, but who knows? But I want to hurry up and finish this before I continue. Let's see. Refining the edges. Something like that. Okay. Stupid ambulance. Sorry for the noise, guys. My window is open. Oh, shit. What did I do? Yeah. My window is open because it's really hot. But then you get stupid outside noises. Okay. I think I'm finishing this border. Yes. Okay. Yeah. And it doesn't have to go all the way down. So something like this. Okay. Let's see. Yeah, that's better. Ships. Okay. That's the last balloon, guys. On page one, and that's the page I was inking in the previous live stream. I finally finished it. I even did the base colors, as you can see. So I'm pretty proud of that. Yeah. And let's bring this one to the center. Yes. And as you can see, I inked everything. Not everything, but. And I'm going to show you guys how I went from layout to ink. So this is the layout. Let's bring it to 100%. Oh, wait. I need to bring all the things to 100. And this also to 100. Okay. Let's watch the... Hey, Jerome, thanks for joining the live stream and tuning in. I appreciate it. So, this is the layout. And I went from layout to ink, as you can see. So, this is the inks. And now I can turn out the layout. And these are the base colors. And I added a tone to indicate the darkness in his... in his room, I can say. But I still have some text balloons. Yeah, there is one. And right there. Let's start with the first text balloon. Let's see. Yeah, that's fine. We want that blue color. I'm going to select it from this one. Let's go back to this one. And I'm going to make the blue a bit darker because it's pretty dark in this room. And create a new layer for the text balloons. There we go. And I still need to create this over here. Let's see. Let's turn out the layout layer for a sec and see how it turned out. Okay. Yeah, I'm liking that. And using the lasso tool to clean out your outer lines, it's really handy because you then get really clean lines or sharp and straight. So I recommend it. Try it out, guys. Okay. Let's see. It doesn't have to be that long. Okay, let's see. Okay. Okay, I think I'm going to increase the balloon itself by a little bit or move it to that side. Yes, okay, that's cool. And with the color, the balloon, the color is just amazing. I'm liking it. And if I like it, I'm going with it. Okay, bit of water, a small water break, I deserved it. What we're going to do with the second balloon, text balloon in this page, is this silhouette, this black female silhouette, is going to be covering the text balloon. But since I rearranged the text board, the panel borders, and everything like that, I have to bring the board, the text balloon, a bit to the inside, because as you can see here, it's been cut out. And yeah, I still have to do a lot on this page, but I'm trying to pencil and yeah, bringing the base colors and something like that. Yes, Royal Samurai, I do make different balloons. Jerome, I'm surprised not more people. Yeah, I'm surprised too, but who knows, maybe all the people that are subscribed or something have very important stuff to do, but I appreciate you guys joining. Like, if it's a thinking text balloon, I can show you actually. if it's if they're thinking, I'm going to make the text balloon like this, and let me color it real quick, red, and I'm going to make smaller circles. Let's do it, smaller circles leading to his head, something like that. See that? That's a thinking text balloon. And when I and the blue text balloon is if people are talking, and you even have a text balloon for if people are screaming, like you can do it this way. And let's color it real quick. And what you can do with this is you can add stuff like this to it. Like a screaming text balloon, you need to make it wild. Yeah, something like that. And as you can see, it's screaming. Like, why aren't more people watching this live stream? Something like that, you know? Let's see. What more text balloons do you have? I think if someone is whispering, you make the text balloon smaller. So that's what you can do. And you have all tons of text balloons, but just look at comics and mangas and see what kind of text balloons they use for different situations. That's all I can say. And you can even do with the screaming text balloon, you can even go like this. Let me show you real quick. And I'm using the selection tool, and I love using the selection tool. It's really quick, and like you can do a lot of stuff with it. It's a lot easier than just coloring and making one big selection, but it does need some practice, I can tell you that. First time I was using Photoshop with the selection tool, yeah, big disaster. You can make it white like this. So you have the color that's the border then. And I did this really quick just to show you guys different types of text balloons, screaming, thinking, and talking. So I'm going to be deleting this, but I hope it helped you guys. Yeah. And the next text balloon. Oh, wait, let me grab the ellipse tool. Okay. I want to make it. Wait, let's do the color first. And then I'm going to make it smaller. Okay. I'm going to make the color darker because it's too bright. Not too dark. Yeah, something like this is good. And I'm going to turn it. Yeah, like I'm going to turn the text balloon with her that it's facing the same angle. Okay. Oops. Yes, something like that. And first, I need to make it smaller. Oh, oops. Saying she's saying only his name, and if she's saying only his name, the text balloon doesn't need to be big at all. So let's not do that then. Yeah, I think this is big enough. And I'm going to bring the opacity down for a bit so I can see the black and erase that part of the text balloon that's being overlapped by her. Okay, delete, delete. Alt. Let's see. Okay. Yeah, I'm liking it. Okay, I'm being really quiet because I'm doing precision work. And when I'm doing that, I can be really quiet. Oops. Shit. I need to switch to this. Wait, no, I don't. I just need to go to this. Ugh. Okay. I'm going to be using my eraser. And carefully erase the edges where it's overlapping. Okay. And let's bring the opacity to 100. Okay. And turn off the layout layer and color. And there we have it, the text balloons on this layer. I'm thinking if I need to add a pointer so that the text balloon can indicate that she's speaking. But yeah, let's add a pointer. Ooh, I can I have a crazy idea, or not so crazy, but just an idea. Let's see how it goes. Very rough, and now refining it. Okay. If I want to add selections, I'm pressing the shift key, and if I want to delete selection, I'm pressing the alt key on my keyboard, or yeah, on my keyboard. Let's call it that. Is it keyboard? I don't know. I don't care. Let's see. Something like that. And that. Yeah. Okay. Let's see. There was. Oh, wait. We're moving this part over here. And yeah, what I am trying to do with this is the text balloon is moving from behind her to in front of her. So I don't know if you guys can see it. I'm doing something with space, and it's a great way to add depth to your drawing. Create a foreground, a background. It's like stuff overlapping each other so that people can know what is where, like what's in the foreground and what's in the background. If you draw your characters just into space and leave everything white and don't add a background, they won't know where your character is. And that can be really like losing your audience. Why am I? That's strange. Let's see. Okay. I'm going to make this bit smaller. I want the lasso tool. Erase that bit more. See. Okay. More.
Hey, I'm liking it, guys. I'm really liking it. Refining the edges over there and there. Okay. Let's see. I'm erasing that. Let's see. You need to make this red. Something like that. And yes, like over there. And this. Okay. I'm finished doing the balloons on this page also. It's only two, and on the next page, on page two, it's four. Yeah, four, that's pretty much. And on the third page, it's three. So now we finished text ballooning two pages and penciling the second page. Now I'm going to be starting penciling the third page. And let's see how that goes. Like, I need to draw his face over here. So, I'm going to bring up his character sheet. And that's what I'll be using as a guidance. As you may, I don't know if some of you got, some of you saw it, but I made a GIF of this guy. Let's see if I can bring it up. I don't know if I can, but we'll see. We'll see. No, I can't. Oh, wait, it's opening. Yeah, let's make this smaller. Okay, yeah, that's good. I hope you guys can see it. And if I press play, you can see the colors changing. And it was pretty fun to do. I made this in Photoshop and After Effects. Oh, it won't loop. That's weird. I'm just gonna press play one more time. I post this on my DeviantArt. I don't know if you guys follow me on DeviantArt. No, I don't have the pages marked. I think I just know which page is what number. I think I have to do that, but I do save them. When I save them as page one, page two, page three, so that when I'm going to open them, I know which page is what. And I also keep them in chapter folders. So you have chapter one, page one, something like that. So I do save them according to the page number. You made a short animation. Ooh, I'm interested to see that. So let's see, guys. This is the character sheet I'll be using. And I'm going to keep it on my other screen. And it's a full body sheet of him with a sword, like his weapon, and some expressions that I'll be using that I think are useful. Also profiles, so I know how he looks from the side. And when you're doing a comic, I do recommend you doing something like this. You don't have to, but it's really easy or handy. It doesn't have to be easy, but it is handy. So let's see. One second, guys. I'm checking out Royal Samurai's animation. Pretty interested to see it. I think I already saw it, but I must have missed it. Let's see. No. Let's see. Oh, here it is. I think this is it. This is it. I'm going to show you guys. Watch with me. I'm going to like it. But from the beginning. That's pretty cool. It's a hand-drawn animation. I like hand-drawn animations. So, nice. Nice, nice, nice. Let's see. Supporting the small artists. That's how I roll. Okay, back to drawing, penciling this. Let's see. I use a pencil layout, red pencil. Something like that. And I got it online for like €4 or I think $3. And it's pretty cool if you have Photoshop. Create a new layer. And let's start. I want to get these pages out as quickly as possible and get them to my, my kind of editor. It's just someone who will check if the pages are okay and if the English is good, because English is not my first language. So I think I make a lot of mistakes with writing it. If you guys have any more questions, keep asking them so I can keep answering them. Let's see. My flashlight. Yes, Jordan. He agreed to help me with the English of the comic, you can actually say. And I'm pretty glad because I was thinking, how am I going to do that? And I know that it would kind of be difficult. And people would be pointing me the whole time on, yeah, the English is not that good, so I want to get that out of the way. Let's see. How many pages is this comic? I don't know yet, but the first chapter is 8 to 9 pages. And I know that's pretty short, but the pages of the chapters won't be long. And it's actually kind of a issue thing rather than a volume. And it's full color, so I think 8 pages in full color equals around 20 pages in black and white. But they are 8 quite interesting pages. And as I already said at the beginning of the live stream, I hope you guys can read it at the end of August. That would be cool, because I'm creating a website for the comic, and probably I'll be posting it on other sites for people to read, but the main website And where I encourage you guys to read it is the website that I'm working on or will be working on soon. First, I need to quickly finish some kind of pages and color them, ink them, and get them out. And then I'll focus on the website. And once that's done, I'll focus on the YouTube channel. And you can already read the lettering that I written with my own hands, but my own handwriting, you can say. Okay. I don't want that kind of expression, so I'm going to change it. He's kind of frustrated, you can say. So I'm trying to get that kind of expression. Yeah, Jerome, you understand me. Like, color takes a lot of time and a lot of extra time. But I think I want this comic in color. Otherwise, I wouldn't invest that much extra time in it. So I'm good with it. I'm only saying it. Oops. Let's see. I'm only saying it so that people can realize how long it takes to actually make a full color comic. Even if it isn't in color, making a comic page is also time consuming. Let's see. Okay. One sec, doing something else, changing the music I'm listening to. That's okay. Oh, by the way, Royal Samurai, I saw your collaboration. Nice, I really liked it. So that you know. So keep it up, the good work. I'm going to flip this for a sec to see if I like it. And I quite like it. Yeah, only the nose is off if I flip it, but it's not that big of a deal. So I think I'm just going to leave it. Let's see, thanks. I'm not. Yeah, I saw you. You're definitely getting better every day. Like, I believe if you draw every day, at least an hour, if you're beginning, in a half hour could also do. And if you really want to go for professional and pro, at least 2 hours a day should already show like a lot of improvement. And in a year, you can get to a professional level. And that's what I noticed with myself also. Like, I try to draw every day. Sometimes it like a half an hour, and other times it's like longer. But if you just keep drawing every day, you're gonna see that you're improving. It's all right, Jerome. I still have to check my mails, but yeah. Did you have fun camping? Where did you went for your camping trip? Let's see. Okay. But I'm going to reply to your mail as soon as I'm done with this live stream, and we're gonna get this collab on. That's weird. Okay, let's see. Okay. Yeah, I definitely saw some improvement going to your videos. So nice. Okay. Getting to his hair. It kind of makes sense, Jerome, so but as long as you had fun. Let's see. I'll be ending the stream soon. I don't want to make it too long, but I had fun streaming with you guys. And I want to thank you, Royal and Jerome, for joining the stream. I think in a small 10 minutes, I'll be ending it. So let's see if I can finish his face before ending the stream. So, rapid speed. High tempo, guys. Find the mates with no limits. Okay, let's see. Yeah, something like that. Like a big part of it, of his hair is being covered by the text balloon here. So I don't have to draw that. That is true, Royal Samurai. Rome was definitely not built in one day. But yeah, if you guys want to stay updated with my comic process, I won't be posting everything on my YouTube channel, but every now and then when I'm uploading a new video, like Let's Practice or Fan Art, I'll be giving a small update about my comic. But follow me on DeviantArt. I'll be posting promo art and small animations and stuff like that. Instagram and Facebook are also places I'll be posting updates, and all those social media links you can find in my description. So that's only if you guys want to stay updated with my comic process. And I'll be doing more live streams where I'll be inking, penciling, coloring comic pages. And I think it's more fun to do it in a live stream. And it keeps me going because if I don't stream or draw with someone else, I can be easily distracted. I don't know if you guys also have that, but I do have it like a lot. That's too high. Let's see. I think I don't have to draw that because it's being covered by the border. So I'm going to focus on this part. I never saw, I'm just smoking something much louder. And soon, yeah, the stream definitely went pretty fast. Like I've been streaming for almost an hour and a half, and I didn't want to make it too long because I would just be babbling. But I think when you have people joining, it can go very fast. And I had fun with you guys answering questions, just talking. And soon I'll be starting a Patreon, and I won't be doing big rewards, more like $1, $3 and $5. And for those prices, you can get these files. And I don't know, you guys said that you were creating your own comic book. So I think looking at these files is pretty handy to see my process. So I do recommend that. And with the Patreon money, I'll be putting it into the website and other stuff solely for the comic so that I can make it better, stronger, and bigger. Let's see, zoom out a bit. Okay, finishing his back hair. Let's see, guys. Yeah, something like this and that. Let me go in and fix his nose for a sec because I don't like this part. Let's see. Yeah, I think that's better. And his mouth is too wide. Let's add some sweat drops, so indicating that he's panicking or something and sweating from the situation. That's enough. Yeah, let's add the inside of his ear. Very simple, not too detailed. I don't like detailing his ear in the comic. Maybe a fairy close-up, but this is pretty simple. So, as you can see, that's how I go from a rough layout to a more refined product. Let's do this side. More to the inside. Okay, and it's back her. Bit more to the inside. Yeah, something like that. And let's streamline this one. Don't not make it not making it too big. So okay, guys. There we have it. Like his head, I think I did it in about 10 minutes. And maybe I'll refine it, but right now I'm liking it, so I'm going to keep it this way. Let's see. Royal Samurai. I checked out the strain and I only watched the first episode so far, but I'm liking it and it's really interesting, so I'll keep watching. And thank you for recommending it. I actually watched the first episode with my mother, so she enjoyed it also. Let's see, let's add some kind of like more. So I think I did a okay job with the expression. I think I saw that he's panicking. And if you can read the text, you'll see that the expression fits him. So, okay, guys, that was it for today. I want to say goodbye and thank you for joining this live stream. I had fun. I'm going to wait one sec before ending it so that anybody can say any last words they have. Let's see more of this to this side. Goodbye, guys. I had a great time. Stay awesome, mates.